It's James Langford from Oklahoma. I know why President Biden doesn't want the media to be here. Because we do have an open border. Last night when we stood under that bridge, we watched as families, if you had a six-year-old or younger come in, within hours you were processed and released into the country. If you were an unaccompanied minor, you were sent over to the Donna facility, which we went and visited. That facility, just in one of the pods that I stood in, is designed for 80 people in that pod, and they had 709 people in that pod when we were there. Literally wall to wall in every one of the plexiglass little cells that they have, and then people flooding out into the hallway in between them. 709 people in a pod set up for 80. So that's what happens to the unaccompanied minors. Families are released into the country immediately. And for single adults that are crossing the border, here's the basic thing that's occurring, and everyone down here knows it, and so do the cartels. They'll release 100 or more adults to be able to go one direction, while 100 or more children and families go a different direction. They turn themselves in, which means Border Patrol has to move to that spot, leaving the rest of the border open for adults with criminal records and others to be able to come across. That is the definition of an open border. Removing the security from one area and making sure that people can cross in that area, and allowing 50% of our Border Patrol to have to be used to do input and data processing. To be able to come and see this wall under construction and to see what wall construction stopping really looks like. Open gates with no power on it, so farmers can't come back and forth. Open gates where they have to actually station somebody from the Border Patrol just to be able to sit at that gate. Haven't put in the technology, no cameras, no lights, no ground sensing technology, and worst of all of it, the area where the levee that protects all these cities and communities, the levee is taken down to be able to start putting in the concrete levee, and for more than 10 miles, those areas are now unprotected with no levee at all. So now we have a hazard this fall when the rainy season comes in this area and the possibility of a hurricane because construction on the wall has stopped, which means construction on the levee has also stopped as well. This is nonsensical what we're seeing in policy, and we saw none of this just 3 months ago. None of this flood was occurring at that time. None of the problems with construction were happening at that time, and we did not see the humanitarian crisis happening at that time. This is something that needs to be addressed and can be addressed by President Biden, but it was very clear when we got here, there's a reason why he doesn't want the press to be here.